morning, folks. I'm Dave Canterbury with Self-Reliance Outfitters and the Pathfinder School. What I'd like to do today is I'd like to do a little short review on the Council Tool Hudson Bay Camp Hatchet. And this is a 2-pound head with a 17-inch hickory handle. And the retail price of this is about $60 with the leather mask. So it's a reasonably priced axe, and it's an American-made axe. And I do a few product reviews from time to time. And sometimes I do product reviews where I buy the product because I want to look at it in terms of getting the product in my hand without necessarily the manufacturer even knowing that I have it. And I want to test it out and trial it and work with it and then decide whether it's something I want to carry on my site or not. And we already carry the Council Tool Woodcraft Series axe on our website, and I'm very pleased with that axe. And I do lots of product testing for lots of different axe companies, lots of different knife companies. I do a lot of work with certain axe companies and certain knife companies, but they're ones that I trust. I don't just go and work with any knife company that comes along or any axe company that comes along. It has to be a reputable company to begin with for me to even be interested in working with them in testing and marketing and doing reviews and things like that. So back to the Council Tool thing, I thought, you know what? There are some less expensive Council Tool axes out there than their premium series. I wonder how good those axes are right out of the box, or what their, you know, selling point would be if we were to bring them into our store, and how well they might sell versus what you might have to do to that axe when you receive it. Because understand that the non-premium series axe, like this hatchet that retails for $60 with the mask, is not going to come razor blade shaving sharp out of the box and perfectly finished. It's a hardware store type axe, and they can't have razor sharp axes on the shelf of a hardware store with every kid fondling the axe that walks through the store. So I expected when I got this axe for it not to be perfect as far as the grind, not to be exactly what I wanted as far as the sharpness of the axe, and I knew I was gonna have to put a few minutes of work into it, maybe a half an hour, to get what I wanted out of it. So when I got the axe, I pulled it out of the box and I looked at it and I thought, you know what, all right, I'm going to sand the lacquer off the handle and I'm going to put some blow on here, some boiled linseed oil. And then I'm going to reshape this head as far as the blade grind profile goes. And I'm going to clean it up a little bit and make it a little bit nicer and cleaner for what I wanted. And then I'm going to start using this axe. And I've been very, very impressed with this axe, because the half an hour of work that I put into it, and I'll show it to you up close and tell you what I did to it, but the half an hour of work that I put into this axe to make it more of a premium style axe is going to give me a lifetime axe that I can use in camp. And I really like, or I'm beginning to like even more, this 2-pound, a little bit heavier head on a little bit shorter handle, because it's easier to put into a pack or put on the back of my bushcraft pack without the handle hanging way out. It's got plenty of weight for busting larger wood, and I did a segment at the beginning of this video with a piece of like 5-inch tulip poplar in log form that I had bucked down and then busted up with this axe. So there's plenty of weight behind this thing, and you can get plenty of leverage with two hands on this 17-inch handle to bust some pretty large logs. Now obviously you'd want something larger than this if you're going to cut down trees of any kind of diameter at all, but that's when you get into a larger or full size axe with a 28-inch handle. As far as a pack hatchet or a camp hatchet goes, this thing's the berries. And I really like Council Tool sheathing, because they're leather sheaths made in America by Weaver Leather Company. This one has the belt loop on it, so you can put it on a belt if you want to. It's a nice heavy duty finely finished sheath. It's got a nice heavy duty snap on it. I really like this sheath, and I haven't been able to tear it up too bad, throwing it around, not really paying much attention to it. It hasn't gotten tore up. And to tell you the truth, I'm overly pleased with this axe at $60. So let's talk real quick. We'll get up close on it here, and I'll show you what I did to this axe as far as the blade goes when I received it. Okay, so let me try to stay out of the shadow here. Okay, you can see that the top of this axe has been finished. It was rough finished when I got it and painted over solid black. I have taken it and ground it all the way down to where there's no paint left on it, and it exposes the eye. And I did that really because I wanted to see what that eye looked like in that axe and how it was wedged in place and things like that. And all of that was covered with paint. So I took all of that off. I polished the pole which was roughly finished. So I polished that pole off to a nice square edge for pounding stakes, because my main idea with this was not only a camp hatchet, but also a trap line axe as well. And then I took and reprofiled this blade, gave it a little bit narrower profile up here on the cheek, so I could put a nice even bevel on here and get a good razor sharp edge on it. Now, you know, this thing is definitely razor sharp beyond the shadow of a doubt. And then I just sanded down the handle with some sandpaper and put a couple coats of blow on here, boiled linseed oil. Other than that, all I did was put my initials in the bottom of the handle here so I'd know who the axe belonged to. But again, for 60 bucks and the half an hour of work I had to put into this thing to make it my own, or profile exactly the way I wanted my axe to be, and coming with a leather mask that's capable of being put on a belt as well, I think it's money well spent. That's just my personal opinion, and I spent the money for this axe, and I think it's money more than well spent, because I'm going to carry this axe for a long time to come. Okay, folks, well, I'm Dave Canterbury with Self Reliance Outfitters in the Pathfinder School here on New Year's Day 2017. I appreciate you joining me for this quick review on the Hudson Bay 17-inch, 2-pound camp hatchet. And I bought this axe again with a couple different agendas in mind. One is, do I want to carry this axe on my website and offer it to my customers? Two, does it take a lot of work to turn a hardware store axe into a premium type axe that I'm proud to carry and that I'm proud to pass on to the generations beyond me? And then three, is this going to work well for a camping and trap line style axe? And I'm pretty convinced that all three of those get the checkbox. So with that said, I appreciate your views. I appreciate your support. I thank you for everything you do for our school, for our family, and for our business, for all of our sponsors, instructors, affiliates, and friends. And I'll be back with another video as soon as I can. Thanks, guys.